then who shall wear the starry crown? Good Lord, show me the way. Oh, sisters, let's go down, let's go down, come on down. Oh, sisters, let's go down, down in the river to pray. As I went down in the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the robe and crown? Good Lord, show me the way. Oh, brothers, let's go down, let's go down, come on down. Come on, brothers, let's go down, down in the river to pray.
Hello everyone, this is Stonewall's Way here, and I'm bringing you another video of Rome 2 Total War. And we left off last time, I was doing a separate campaign, and it was the Athens campaign. And it was suggested by one of my friends I went to Bible college with in Louisiana. And he suggested that I play as Athens, and it was a good campaign so far. Had some difficulties playing that, but I had a different campaign that I was playing besides Athens, and that was Massilia. Now the thing about Massilia, it was a fun campaign, and I had conquered most of northern Italy, just the northern, I forget what they call that part of Italy, but I had conquered where Venice used to be, or would be, and I went through my saves, and I noticed that the game did not save. And I was like, oh, you gotta be kidding me. I have to play over that province again. And it hit me, I don't really have that many viewers yet, so it really doesn't matter if I play Massilia over again or not. And I probably can play Massilia over again, but I think what I want to do is play another faction. And I was thinking, why not play something we haven't played before, and that is Hannibal at the Gates. Watch, the music just changed. Hannibal at the Gates. I was thinking we should play as Carthage and Hannibal at the Gates. It starts in 218 BC, and it's during the first, is it the first Punic War or the second Punic War? Anyways, it's one of the Punic Wars. And we're going to see if we can defeat the Romans before they can defeat us. Our initial challenge is easy, but I'm going to set it to hard. I'm going to look at anything here. I'm going to make the battle time limit 40 minutes. We don't need any advisor help. That'll be good. We have to control 50 settlements. And complete control of 6 provinces. We'll go over that in the game, but let's go ahead and start. And Rome 2 Total War had its setbacks when it first came out. Many people know about the many glitches and system failures and just downright just horrible graphics that Rome 2 Total War first came out with. But the game, the assembly team, the Sega team, did their best and fixed those problems, and it's a good game.
Hannibal, now, my son, stand before the gods and swear, from this day until your last, that you will always be an enemy of Rome.
The treaty that binds you.
Your treaty is unacceptable!
I will remind you, the last time Carthage resisted Rome, your fathers were buried in the fields of Sicily. Those that didn't greet the dirt with open arms We sent to serve Neptune in the waters of the Agathos. The Mediterranean is undoubtedly ours, not yours. You gifted us whatever scraps of it you held when you and your mercenaries scurried back to your barbaric fishing village. And I am sent here to ask you to decide between peace and open conflict, as if you truly have a choice.
I choose war.
Take that, arrogant Roman.
War with Rome has come again. Finally. Our recent capture of Saguntum has cut the last bind of peace between our peoples. Rome will know only suffering from this day forth. In time, our armies will swarm across all Italy. Rome's allies will bow to Carthage or face annihilation alongside their Latin masters. Our home city in Africa may be secure, but as the majority of our forces are abroad, we must be wary of an enemy strike against it. In Iberia, further gains must be made. The land is rich in silver to aid our war against Rome. It is time for Carthage to ascend and dominate the Mediterranean. Baal Hamun be praised.
Okay, from the ashes, we will burn brightest. Complete control for province, either by direct ownership or through client states. Plus 2,500 treasury. Control the Ebro Valley is of paramount importance to our ambitions. Control the four settlements, either by direct ownership or through client states. Cesis, Lerda, Salduba, and Aruna. Cesis. Hold on. I'm going to look at that real quick. Cesis. Erda. Salduba. We already basically own that. And Aruna. So we need to control that valley. These guys are our allies. Alright. This is my first Hannibal at the Gates campaign I've ever played, and I think I remember vaguely just testing the campaign a long time ago and trying it out, but I never really went through with it. And it's something that I really missed out on, because at the height of its day, this was the DLC to have, was Hannibal at the Gates. You get to play as Hannibal. I also watched, there was a guy I watched that's real famous right now that got me into the Total War games, was a Hare of Carthage. And watching his campaign on Rome 2 Total War was just awesome. Get to watch him just with all his humor and just having a good old time. He used to call his, sending in his peasants. He had sent in all his peasants to their death. Oh. Grand guy. Alright, so the way my playstyle is, it's more of a historical playstyle. I like to follow history of how I feel that history should have went, and how it should have happened, and how it would have historically felt. I guess that's just my playstyle. So we're going to go ahead and look at the chapter objectives, what we have to do while we're trying to get control of the four provinces. We get $2,000 if we forge a defensive and military alliance with the following faction, the Arvaki, which are right here. If we establish trade relations with the following faction, Libya, which is right here, and research the following technology, diplomats. And we're going to go ahead and look at our technology. And here's diplomats right here. So we'll go ahead and research that so we get the coin that we need. So let's go ahead and zoom out so we get a view of our territory. We have Carthage here, Hadrumentum here. We've got all this territory here. We have one of our generals here. Have a general here. Have a navy here. Have a general here, navy here, and another general. Who owns this island? Oh, that's unplayable. No one owns the island. Okay. And we own the northern tip of this. Let's go ahead and look who we're at war with. We're at war with the Sesitani, which are right next door to our military allies. Let's see if our Vaki hate us, but we're going to try to make things right with our Vaki so we can continue the historical play there. They're military allies with the Vaki, which are over here, and they're at war with the Carpenti over here. All right, who else do we have to worry about? The Turdetani. Yes, the Turds. What are we going to do about the Turdetani? Now, in Hair of Carthage's campaign, the Turdetani are notorious for their debauchery, but mainly for their annoyingness. They're just very annoying faction. right now, they're client states of us, but it looks like they're going to break from us in a while, and so is the Oritani. So, I think what we should do is counter-strike before they break. Let's see who else we're... We are client state of Libya. Let's see if we can get that trade agreement with them, which is low.
Enjoy the pleasures.
We're going to probably try to establish relations with Libya better on our first turn. Let's see, the Massilia. We're going to go ahead and try to get a trade agreement. Awesome.
I am humbled by your honor.
All right. So, Rome. Are we at war with Rome? We are at war with Rome. So, we have to worry about Rome coming to war with us. How about Syracuse? Syracuse does not like us. Who owns this? Rome owns Corsica and Sardinia. I do not like these two islands being under the control of Rome, so we would have to constantly worry about our capital being attacked. We need to have a buffer between Rome and Carthage, and I think these islands would be the buffer. But where is Syracuse? All right. Let's see. Is this Syracuse's land? I'd have to see. All right. I'm going to go ahead and sail my navy over here. Just to see. Ah. It's controlled by Rome. And there's really no one there, so we're going to go ahead and sail our fleet back. Actually, we can recruit units. And I don't think I'm going to recruit Sacred Band. What should I recruit? Let's see over here. We have a harbor, a dry dock. If I convert this to a dock shed, what do I get? A dock shed enables javelin men, dry dock, sacred band, assaults. Assault titries, recruitment 760, recruitment cost 1260. It looks like our best option is to actually convert this to a dock shed, but we don't have the money, but there will be other ways to get money. And let's see if we can find those other ways.
I greet you as befits your reputation.
Hi.
Now, friend,
let's demand
speak
money.
Mainly, so that.
All right.
I came.
We just got some more money. We're gonna go ahead and convert this to a dock shed, so we get cheaper units from our port. That consumed most of our money. We're gonna go ahead and march this army over here.
I want hourly patrols.
Friends of 104. We got an army here too. These guys don't like us much. Their military allies are Romans. They have 4 units. Let's see what we got in this town. Farming settlement. What do we got over here? We're gonna march them. Oop, nope, nope, nope. Darn it. Oh well. Oh well. We just trespassed into another territory. Oh gosh. Alright, let's go look at this continent. What do we got here? We got a military camps. Let's see where our generals are at. Which one? I think this is Hannibal. Yep, Hannibal Barca. Okay. What do we want to do here? We are at war with Rome, and we are at war with Massilia, and we're at war with the Sesitani, and war with the Imperoni. The best course of action would to be send the spy over.
I would travel many miles for Carthage. I shall rest a while.
They have a small army here. So probably my greatest advantage is to march my army. Over here.
Ready for further orders.
How can I serve you?
And this diplomat.
Truth may walk through the world unarmed.
We're going to station this army in here. Is there any factions that we could trade with? Lusitani?
Greetings to you. I trust you.
No. The Gallini?
I greet you as befits your reputation.
Trade with them. And that's about it. Alright, let's go ahead and turn. An edict. Alright, I think we have an edict over here. Maybe over here. Alright, so let's see what edict we should get. We should get tax harvesting. That way we get more income.
My people wish to offer you this gift of gold, if you will take it.
It's really tempting to take their gold right now, but... but no.
Gods, give me strength. Have we jabbered on for so little result?
That money would have came in handy, though.
I live to serve the mighty Carthage.
I'm gonna go see what happened to their army.
As you come out.
They're right here. I'm gonna march my army right here. An end turn, so that way we have the river as protection. And we're gonna go ahead and look at our general. This lady likes barbarians. Arrogant wife, oh no. Skilled ambushes, commanding general. Mago, Barca. Sea Lakes. It's a good admiral. Harmony. Administrator. Welfare. Let's go ahead and look at the politics screen. Looks like the Hanoi dynasty has 78 influence, and the landowners party has 80, while we have 47 influence. We have 142 judges. So it's fairly even spaced. We're gonna see if this guy can, or we can't do it. Oh, it's only for ruling party members, okay. We're gonna seek a spouse for this guy. Educated wife, awesome. That guy is deployed. This guy is moved.
It is an honor to serve. We fight for you, my lord. To your duties, men. I live going upon. Yes, I live to serve. Get to it, men. Hard on the oars. Set up a blockade.
We're going to go ahead and land our troops over here and take over that settlement. And meanwhile, while we're there, we have this army.
We fight. Lady Tanit, bless our journey. Have further orders? Heading on board.
Uh-oh.
I make the offer of peace only from a position of strength. To offer peace otherwise is simple.
These guys are cautious and loyal, so they have a strong reliability rating. And I have no any objectives which ask me to take their city yet. So I'm going to accept this peace treaty. Defender, Carthage, aggressor, Massilia, and one side of the alley.
It is a simple gift, gold. but one that many appreciate, as we are sure you will.
I'm going to take their gold. I have no war with Massilia right at this moment. I will later, but not at this moment. I'm gonna go ahead and do the ore over here. Now it looks like the Roman fleet has 6 ships. How many ships do we have? We have 4. I'm not concerned about the Roman fleet right now. We're gonna go ahead and land our fleet. But it would be wise to put a general here. Let's go ahead and look at our, faction. This guy right here is Hasdrubal Barca. I don't know where Hasdrubal Barca is at right now.
Fleet reporting, my lord.
I live to serve the mighty Carthage.
Mago Barca? Where is that other guy at? Never mind, I'm getting caught up on a wild goose chase. Let's go ahead and focus on the task at hand. We're over there. Now let's go over here to see. Looks like they went into the city. We're gonna go ahead and encircle and besiege. Those guys aren't gonna be a problem, but these guys will. They could possibly march their army and attack me. I'm gonna probably hire a few mercenary Iberian swords. We don't need mercenary citizen cab yet.
At your service.
Let's see. We're gonna go ahead and increase the strength of this army. We're gonna get a line of Carthaginian hoplites. Libyan Pelstist, and we'll go ahead and cancel that for now. But we'll go ahead and slowly increase the strength of that army. Bariacus. Go ahead. We're gonna go ahead for greedy. No. We're gonna go for economist. What are the Romans up to? That's not good. They're already trying to outwit us.
Ready for
your orders.
Well, we have no choice but to follow them and defeat them at their own game.
Setting forth in the name of Carthage.
I think we can defeat these Romans. I know I put my men in peril, but they've seen worse. I'm gonna recruit a champion, and I'm gonna have him go spy over on this settlement so we can see exactly what's over there. We're not researching any technologies. Looks like we completed one of our objectives, which was to research diplomats. It gave us 1,000 coin. And the next thing is to try to get a trade relation with Libya and to form a defensive alliance with Arvaki. So let's go ahead and get that technology first. We're gonna get physical conditioning. And let's see about Libya.
Welcome, friend. Let's...
Not gonna happen yet. Alright, let's see what the Romans do. They're turning around. Alright, we're being attacked. And we're gonna go ahead and fight this battle on land. This is what Rome 2 is all about. Rome 2 Total War. Let's see what units they have. Oh, missed that. We can see it.
War elephants!
We got some war elephants. We're gonna put them in the back of the line. We don't wanna waste our war elephants.
Our orders, loyal sons of Carthage. Iberian swords!
Libyan infantry! Malay infantry!
Malay cavalry at your command!
Cavalry!
Malay cavalry!
Ready. Javelin men!
Ballista!
War elephants!
We're gonna play defensively because we have artillery. We're just gonna move up a little bit so we get some space. Let's go ahead and see what we're dealing up against. It's Qatari spearmen, veteran shield warriors, Iberian swordsmen. Qatari spearmen. So I think our target is this. They're disappeared. We're gonna use some explosive round. And we're gonna target the shield warrior. Cool things about artillery is that you can auto fire it, and I think I remember how to do it. I think you press insert.
We have discovered the enemy's hidden units.
Oh yeah, here you go. There it goes. Let's see if it hits. Oh, I think it's gonna hit. Oh! Oh man! Alright, let's see if we can do it again. There we go! I could do this all day. Let's see. Oh, just right. All right, we gotta get back. Our skirmishers, we were busy shooting the artillery. I wasn't even paying attention to my skirmishers.
The men are wavering.
Oop, it looks like we lost a skirmisher.
Javelin men!
As you wish.
Cavalry! Pack the Argos!
Diamond charge bonus melee attack. I just love those charges. They're amazing. They're routing. Let's get our
artillery.
Go ahead and get our skirmishers put into play. Right over here.
What curse you? Set fire on them!
We're gonna get a rear charge, hopefully. Devastate these veterans.
One of our units has used all its ammunition.
And I'm gonna fire at those tribesmen.
Libyan infantry!
One of our units has used all its ammunition.
Go ahead and have them retreat through here. I'm gonna take my elephants and we're gonna go ahead and charge with our elephants.
Our general is under attack.
Oh, those javelins are going to do some damage to our...
Elephants ready for battle!
Cavalry!
We need to get our cavalry out of there. Rome Total Wars, the elephants used to go berserk like crazy, and we're gonna retreat our cavalry.
Our men flee the field of battle. This is a shameful display.
We're holding good.
Libyan infantry.
I'm gonna go ahead and retreat our Libyan infantry.
Malista!
Looks like we ran out of ammunition on our ballista. This is good right here because these spears can't really hurt our elephants because our elephants are pretty impervious to damage.
The battle is turning in our favor.
Battle, because we want to destroy as much of the enemy as possible so to keep them from returning to the map. Actually Stonewall's Sol Jackson's maxims for military campaigns. He said once you defeat the enemy, it's best to take advantage if they're defeated, take advantage of it. If they're running away, to take advantage of the fruits of victory, which is running down the enemy as much as take out as much as possible. If they're routing, that's the best time to get as many kills as you can, and it prevents the enemy from having more men against you next time. Yeah, we don't want these guys fighting us next time. We want to even the odds more out, so if I have to auto-resolve, the auto-resolve will be favorable to what I'm looking for. We lost 777 men, but they lost 1,299. Not bad. I could have done better. I was so kind of got sidetracked with showing off the battle and everything, but if it's a more important battle next time, I will pay more attention. Alright. We're going to kill the captives. We're gonna go ahead and auto resolve the attack. Occupy. We're gonna convert this settlement. And we're just gonna convert it for now. Oh no. We got another army. And it's the army I was afraid of.
My lord.
I can't turn and run.
All men must serve.
Let's go ahead and see if we can't sabotage them. No.
At your command.
We're gonna go ahead and recruit some mercenaries. Since we got the money, and we're not going to convert that right now. We're going to go ahead and recruit the mercenaries. They've got just a lot of spearmen and a lot of swordsmen. So what can we do to counter that? Well, we can get some mercenary hoplites. We can get noble fighters. We can get mercenary Italian swordsmen. Celtic light horsemen. Mercenary Scutari. And how much are these? Mercenary Iberian swordsmen. Base morale 44. And mercenary Scutari, base morale 55. I'm trying to think of the best troops I can get here. The phalanx is okay. We'll get one of these. Let's see. Two of these. One of those. Alright, so that should be enough to deal with at least part of the army.
How can I serve Carthage?
We have elephants, they don't, so we can defeat them. Okay. Now to deal with other problems. The other problems meaning Rome. Where is Rome? Here. Here's Rome. We're gonna follow this army.
Curse you! Row! All hands to the oars! Hard on the oars! All hands to the oars!
Alright, we're gonna go get the skill for Hannibal Barca. And we're gonna give him... We're gonna give him commander. Darn it, that Roman force keeps on getting slipping away. Enter war on side of Ali. I've got it. I know what to do with that Roman force. Just didn't think of it before. The aggressor is the Turnitani, and the defender is the Oritani. We're in a war inside of Alley. I don't know who it was.
How can I serve Carthage?
We can't reach like that, right? Well, this is all we gotta do. We break that army off. And then sail over here. Alright. Now, looks like we're outnumbered, but this is just a piece of cake. I'm going to show you how easy it is to win naval battles that involve armies. See, we got these nice assault tetris, and they got this nice thing called the ram. Now let's go ahead and look at the enemy fleet. Notice one thing that's missing with these ships. There is no ram, so these ships are gonna pay dearly for not going to battle without a ram.
Assault ships ready for orders.
Look at this hard work, men. Numbers alone do not win battles. It is your college, my skill in command, that will carry us through this day. Make ready and await your orders. Treat my fighters and ready.
Support ships at your
command. We await your word.
Assault ships ready to attack.
We are at your command.
Loyal sons of Carthage.
At your command, support ships. Give me more oars.
missiles await your orders!
One of our ships is being boarded!
And that's the downside for being ships without rams. Another strategy when you're doing this is keep on going backwards.
One of our units has used all its ammunition.
On your order! Move out! Move to position! Get moving! Move out! Get moving!
Tracking us!
One of our ships is being boarded.
Move out! Move to position!
Come on, ram him.
Our general has fallen.
Oh, darn it, we lost our general. No. All right, we sunk the ship.
Good, my fighters are ready.
Well, that's not a piece of cake as I made it sound, but it's fun.
Get moving. Move out.
I just wish these guys would have held out longer. These aren't Triarii.
To the oars!
Our men flee the field of battle! This is a shameful display.
Alhamun has blessed us! Give me more oars!
Our men flee the field of battle. This is a shameful display.
Why did it stop? Oh my gosh, I can't believe it.
Move to position! Get moving! To the oars! Forward, warriors of Carthage!
Come on, ram him. Ram him, come on. Come on, ram him. Come on, ram him. Hit him. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. What?
An entire unit has perished.
Pay for what they've done. We will make them pay. right, let's ram it.
One of our ships is being boarded.
To the oars! Move out! Get moving! Set the oars! To the oars! Move out!
Okay.
Get me more oars! Get moving!
Looks like we barely won this battle by the skin of our teeth, but it's okay. Won the battle. And we got an achievement. Evocatus. What is that? Evocatus. Let's see that achievement. What is that? Oh, here it is. Evocatus. Evocatus. Oh, here it is. Complete 100 hours of gameplay. I played a lot of this game, I guess. Alright, I'm going ahead and enslave the captives. And we're gonna get assault tetrays, and we're gonna put in this guy.
It is an honor to serve you.
We're gonna send this spy in. I guess he's as slow as the infantry. Oh boy. I don't know how. Oh, here we go. The screen was turned the wrong way. Wasn't seeing things the right way. This army has gone off in the land.
At your command.
I'm gonna go ahead and march. March our army over here. I actually have an idea. So this is my idea. I'm going to get some more money, but I'm going to recruit some ships, and I'm going to follow this fleet, find out where they're going, and we're going to attack it, sink it at sea, and then take over the settlement, which is a part of our objectives to pacify the Ebro Valley. We hold two settlements that we need. That'll be this one we need, and then we need one more, which would be Iruna, which is held by the Vascones. What's our relations with them? Vascones, we're neutral, which is good. The Arvaki still do not like us. We gotta improve that relationship with them, but we just don't have the money right now to do that. We've got a nice army here. We're at war with the Turdetani. They've got a small army here. We need to deal with the Turdetani because they're going to march over here and do damage to us. They're going to be very annoying. So we got to figure out how to deal with them. They're recruiting, they're making their army stronger. armies out in the open. How much people we have? Carthago Nova is well defended. I have an idea. So I'm going to march my army. It's going to take us about 3 turns. I'm going to march them here. Or about here. And then I'm going to march them over here to where this crossing is. They're going to attack me here. Oop. They're going to attack me here with this army and this army, since they outnumber me. And that's where we'll defeat them. We'll defeat them right here at this bridge. We're not going to hire any mercenaries this turn. Let's go ahead and turn. Lusitani, Defender Saltikai. I'm going to war inside a valley.
I propose a simple treaty between equals and friends. All can profit by this offer.
I'm
going to
defend, man.
Offer.
Money. No! Military ambitions. Let's do civil development. The beginning stages of this campaign, we should develop our economy. And I'm going to go ahead and get economist. Let's go ahead and see where this fleet is sailed. They sailed right here, which is excellent. We have 8 ships. They have 14 men. We've got a fleet of 0 ships. Well, that's a bummer.
Balhamun be praised. Assembling the fleet.
I'm wondering if I should make more ships or if I should go ahead. No.
Fleet reporting, my
lord. Who is my admiral? This dude. What is he known for? I gotta look at the politics of this guy. Prosperity. He's respectful. We're gonna replace him. Who do we want to get rid of? This guy has hope. This guy has austerity and is diplomatic, so we could use him. So we're going to send him as a diplomat to the Arvaki. Actually, first to Libya. Good. This guy is respectful and prosperity. This guy has mercy and my phlegmatic. We're gonna go ahead and make this guy the sacrificial lamb. But it looks like he's in an army right now, so we can't do that. We might as well replace Landowner's Party. He has hope. An inner circle. Well, I just guess we're just gonna have to hope he doesn't die. Yeah, we can't replace with anyone else. So
how can I serve
wrong or feel the kiss of the whip?
We're going to go ahead and declare, well, actually, before we declare war, do these guys have any allies? They have a defensive ally. The Aletakovans. Covans, they hate us. And they're recruiting a huge army. Great. Great. I'm gonna talk to these guys real quick.
I am sure you have many pleasantries for me, but please don't bother. Talk of meat, not honey.
Break defensive alliance with the Ligrets. We're gonna go ahead and do that. That way we can capture this settlement. If they go to war with us, big deal. We'll just fight them. We'll move on. We have this river as our defense, our defense. So if they take this settlement, or if they attempt to take this settlement, we gotta get our men healed up before we attack them. That's what we're gonna do first.
Ready for orders.
But we are gonna attack this unit here. Let's go ahead and see what else is going on in the world. We got this army here. They're going across to attack this settlement.
How can I serve Conquer? No! Curse you, Rome! The men must rest.
There's no one in this settlement right now. It has 6 units, though. Principes, Rorii, 2 plebs, and 2 levies. We're gonna go ahead and take this this champion and spy on this settlement over here. We're at war with these guys. We got this army here. We're gonna go ahead and march them in here and recruit more men. And in turn. Darn it, the Turdetani beat us. We're not gonna be able to defeat them. Go ahead. March them.
Is that all, my lord? At once.
March them right there. We got a formidable army in Tingis. Alright, so this is it.
Our warriors will march, and our women. Nay!
Alright, it's a formidable force that we're dealing with, but I think we can do it. They've got very little missile troops. If we play this right, we can sink all their ships and have very minimal losses ourselves. So that's what we're going to do in our next video, is we're going to try to win this naval battle. And this is Stonewall's Way, saluting you and thanking our vets. Might be watching right now is my friend Skylar. He's in the army. Thank you for your service, Skylar. And if you haven't shook a veteran's hand, go ahead, shake one, and let them know that you appreciate their service. This is Stonewall's Way signing out.